Hello, welcome everybody. I'm going to be showing you how to install the fun to chess diagram script for InDesign so you can create chess diagrams for your chess publications. I have a document here open with some filler text. First, we need to open the scripts panel. On the menu, go to Windows, Utility, Scripts. And we're going to need also the text wrap panel, which is under Windows, Text Wrap. Next step is to install the script, and we're going to store it under our user folder. To find the location, you're going to right-click on the user folder icon in the scripts panel. Then select the option to reveal Finder on your Mac. If you are using Windows, you're going to see Reveal in Explorer. I have done this already. Have downloaded and unzipped the script. Now, we're simply going to drag or copy-paste it into the user folder. The next thing you need to do is install the Chess Meridia font. I have done this step already, so I'm going to continue and show you how the script works. On the text wrap control panel, make sure that wrap around bounding box is selected. Otherwise, when you create your dialog box, it will not wrap around your text. The first time you open the fun to diagram script, the default fenstring will be at chess starting position as the input. Options included are invert board, a double or single frame, coordinates for left, right, top, bottom, and a default font size of 26. For example, we're going to change the font size to 18. We have created our first chess diagram. You can see us from White's point of view with our coordinates on left and bottom. Move this to the side for now. We're going to create another diagram. Change the option to a single frame and click to invert board so the black pieces are on bottom. Note that it saved our last input of 18 for the font size. It will always save whatever last setting you used. We created the same fenstring, but now we're looking at from black's point of view. Note it arranged the algebraic coordinates from black's point of view. Be aware that these are text characters and in order for the diagram to show properly. The font size and the leading must be the same. If the leading or the font size are not the same, it would distort our diagram. The other thing that you should know is that with this script, you can create illegal chess positions. For example, we have two white kings and a black king. I have included additional glyphs in the font. On the menu, go to Window, Type and Tables, Glyphs. On the Glyphs panel, you can see all the characters from the Chess Meridia font. You can create manually the positions yourself if you wish. As you can see, there are other special characters available like bullets and X's. With their perspective light and dark squares. You can use these characters in your fenstring by adding them. For example, add an X here on the fenstring. We added a square with an X to the diagram. To add a bullet, you use the plus sign. It has to be a lowercase x in order for the X to appear. If you use a uppercase X, the script won't work. Let me give you some examples of how these characters can be used. Let's say you want to create a diagram where you're illustrating. all the possible moves where the king can go. Here we have a black king, and the white pawns will be representing where the black king can go. I'm using Hyarch's Chess Explorer to set up the position and create a fence string. You can use chess.com or any other software to create your fence strings. Now we are going to paste our fence string, and knowing this new information, we're going to replace the pawns represented by the p's with an x, a lowercase x, to illustrate all the squares that the king can move. If you don't like the x, again, you want to use the plus sign to create the bullets. And that's how easily you can create the chess diagrams. Thank you for watching, and have fun designing.